The real question about human evolution is, why are we here and none of the others are?
That's a tough question. Human beings evolved on a very, very dynamic and changeable planet. In fact, the past 6 million years was one of the most volatile environmental fluctuation that we've seen in Earth's history. Fluctuations between very cold and warm, between very rainy and arid drought conditions. When Homo sapiens emerged out of Africa, there had been a long history of adaptability. We were the adaptable species, able to take on the crunch time of great instability in the environments.
Even in your lifetime, you can think about the adaptations you've made to different environments. You all would never have imagined standing here in front of me with masks on, and yet here we are. We can adapt culturally, behaviorally, and then we can teach our offspring.
They brought with them this, in a sense, cocoon of culture, this ability to speak in probably more effective ways than Neanderthals could. They were able to exchange things like jewels and beads, sources of identity, and also stone raw material for making tools over hundreds of miles.
The way humans have dispersed across the globe, there's not that many geographic barriers that humans can't overcome. Like, we could put people into space now.
Humans not just mastered sort of changing rock into tools, but they also mastered imbuing the world with a particular kind of meaning.
They had a richer symbolic culture that they brought with them.
An imagination that allowed them to pick something up and see in that stone, not just a tool, but maybe a half-man, half-lion creature that meant something to them.
Meaning, whether it was spiritual or philosophical or artistic or scientific, that pursuit of meaning was part of the toolkit that evolved in our species, Homo sapiens. And that is absolutely critical in living in a world of uncertainty and disruption.
And today, every single human has the capacity to be here right now, but to imagine, to daydream, to believe well beyond anything they've ever experienced. That's incredible. And I think that's part of the story of what's made us so successful.
It's always that threshold question, what does it mean to be human? Science can help inform certain aspects of that question, but it's really a whole range of human endeavors that inform that question. Obviously, religion and philosophy, ethics, the values that we learn as we're growing up, the books that we read, the arts in general, performing arts. These are all areas where people gain a sense of their own meaning as human beings. Even just everyday experience, we develop a concept of that. There is an opportunity for a dialogue between science and all of those other areas of endeavor that really do heighten our sense of meaningfulness of what humans are all about.